Hi everyone, this is Grace. How are you? You know, we would live up to age 100 and we might be working until age 80. So let's redesign your life. I mean, I really want you to redesign your life. There are three things you need to work on: your relationship, your health, and money. Today, I'd like to talk about relationship or marriage. There is an article by Japanese business magazine that I saw this morning. It was a horror story about a Japanese couple in Japan. You know, these days, the divorce rate is rising in Japan. In a certain statistics, one out of three couples end up divorced in Japan these days. So they are catching up to the American couples. And that story was quite interesting. It was a story about Japanese divorcee. The lady already divorced once, and she was desperate to get remarried before age 40 or something. And she fell in love with a farmer boy from a farming area. And then just to test before she made a commitment, she moved into his village. And then even they are the same Japanese, but there are different regional customs and cultures. So to make long story short, she canceled her engagement. She went back to Tokyo and she found another man. She got remarried and have a baby and she is happy. So when I read the story, I thought it was funny, but also it made me think why my marriage is lasting this long. My husband and I are international students. We met in a freshman English class at the University of Southern California. And I never thought I would end up marrying him because he wasn't my Prince Charming. But, you know, life is full of surprises, so I end up marrying him. But even at my wedding, since we are getting married in Los Angeles, back then, already the divorce rate in big cities in the United States, like New York, San Francisco, Los Angeles, the divorce rate was already 50%. So I didn't expect too much. I thought I would end up with a divorce. And actually, when you least expect, you would get it, right? So I didn't expect we would last this long, but we were such a happy couple. So go back to the story. So what I'm saying is, there is a one critical factor probably could predict whether or not you would end up divorced, I think, based upon my personal experience. That is family value system. What you learn from your parents would be a very critical factor whether or not you would have a happy marriage. To make it more specific, I think it is very, very important, rather critical, for you to visit the other party's parents before you make a commitment, before you decide to engage, or before you even consider marrying that person. Because most likely, your boyfriend or girlfriend would expect you to be almost the same as their parents. Like, your boyfriend would expect you to be just like his mother, or your girlfriend would expect you to be like her father. For instance, if your boyfriend is raised by a mother doesn't matter married or single mother or what. If the mother is a stay-at-home mom, and if she's such a great chef, she can cook such a great family dishes, I think he would expect you to be the same. You know, he would expect you to be always cooking dinner at home, or, you know, for those holidays, he would expect you to cook, you know, holiday dinner, invite friends and families. Or if your girlfriend's father is like my father, if your girlfriend's father is really spoiling your girlfriend, you know, if your girlfriend is her daddy's eyes, you know, apples in the eyes, then she would expect you never say no to whatever she wants to buy. Really, that's what I mean. So I was so blessed because we were international students at the USC. I didn't have a chance to fly to his country to visit his parents. I kind of took a, that was the my life's biggest gamble, I think. Without knowing his family, without meeting his parents, I already made a commitment, right? And likewise, he met my parents before we got married. But anyhow, so good thing was his parents were working parents. They were small business owners, and the mother was helping the father. So that was good. So he see the mother working. And also, our families are very similar. You know, even though I am from Japan, my husband is from Southeast Asia, but we have one thing in common, or two things. Both of our parents are working, business owners, and we had domestic helpers. So my husband didn't expect me to do all the housework. He grew up in a family environment where the houseworks are done by domestic helper. And me too, we had a domestic helper in Japan. So I didn't have, my mom didn't really have to do housework. Only when our maid had a day off for vacation, then we have to do it. But otherwise, we didn't have to do it. So that is the blessing. Because I am a career person, I always wanted to have my own career. And I knew I had a 50-50 chance of getting divorced, be in the States. So I wanted to be a career person. I wanted to have my own income. I didn't want to, you know, rely on my husband's income. And I enjoy myself. I love myself working out there, making money, not the, you know, stay-home mom. I hate housework. I don't like children. I love career. And my husband happened to be the same value. He doesn't like children. And he loves business. He loves investments. And he grew up with a family, with a domestic helper. His mom was working. And actually, his mom was a terrible cook. That's a blessing too. So he didn't expect me to cook either. Good. So every time, you know, I'm working and I'm tired, I just call my husband, hey, do you want to go out for dinner or do you want to take out something? And he's fine. Whereas if, you know, if your boyfriend or if your husband, mother, if your mother-in-law love to do cook, if your mother-in-law is a gourmet chef, can you imagine? That would be a nightmare for me because I'm not interested in cooking. I hate cooking, but I love to eat. I love to go out. But if my husband would ever expect me to cook every single day, we would break up a long time ago. So really, the only thing you have to do before you make a commitment is go visit his or her parents. See what the father-in-law is doing, see what the mother-in-law is doing or saying. If they say, oh, good, you married, you live with us, you have many babies, and make sure you take care of us after we retire, okay? I don't know if that's the lifestyle you like to have. Go ahead, marry into the family, but not me. I'm not gonna be housewife. I'm not gonna become domestic helper. I'd rather keep working. I'd rather have money to hire domestic helper. I wanna be making money to be able to hire caretaker if parents or parents-in-law require care. I'm not gonna be the caretaker or caregiver. Okay, so that's a very simple thing, but very crucial for your happy marriage. Okay, that's all for today. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.